So all the best to both teams and let's get started. So Ajit, what's your choice of topic, please?
I'll go with the animation companies.
Okay, and your first question. When one thinks of the Academy Award for Best Animated Feature, the names of Disney and Pixar come to mind. However, the inaugural award in this category from 2001 was won by which company? The movie was based on a book by William Steig, and the company had been founded in 1995 by David Geffen, Jeffrey Katzenberg, even more famous third person.
This is DreamWorks, SKG, Spielberg, Shrek.
That is the correct answer, and you had all aspects of it. It was DreamWorks, SKG. Well done. Which studio temporarily suspended all production following the retirement of a famous director in August 2014? Then, in February 2017, they announced that the director was coming out of retirement to direct one last film for his grandson, based on the 1937 novel How Do You Live? And this film will be released this year. This film is set to be released in July this year.
This is Studio Ghibli, Miyazaki.
Correct. Again, on both counts, Studio Ghibli and Miyazaki. So you have a full set on that. Jomar, what is your choice of topic, please?
Ilvins, please.
Ill wins and your first question.
Mm.
That shouldn't be predictive of what happens. A hot, dry wind that blows in Egypt and the Levant is associated with terrible sandstorms gets its name from the Arabic word for 50, as it reputedly blows for 50 days at a stretch. Tintin encounters it in the land of the Black Hole, and the Hebrew Bible attributes the parting of the Red Sea to it. Which wind is this?
Sirocco.
It's not the Sirocco, I'm afraid. It passes to your team.
Julius, please go for it.
It's
Yes,
the
Julius.
Habub.
It's not the Habub.
I'll go for it.
Go for it, Jan.
Yes, Jan.
Okay. Khamsin.
Khamsin is the right answer. It is a Khamsin, so good point on the screen.
Nice.
Second question, Jomar. It is a cold northwesterly wind that blows from southern France into the Gulf of Lyon. It gets its name from the Occitan word for masterly as it reaches wind speeds of up to 185 kilometers per hour. Which wind is unique as the only wind that has lent its name to two Nobel laureates in literature?
This should be Mistral, right?
That is the right answer. It is Mistral. The Nobel laureates are Frederick and Gabriella. Well done. Utkarsh, your choice of topic, please.
I'll take stock ticker symbols.
Stock ticker symbols. And the first question. Before it was acquired by the PE firm Paulson and Company in 2013, Steinway Musical Instruments used to trade at the New York Stock Exchange under the ticker symbol LVB. What did that stand for?
Is this Ludwig van Beethoven?
It is Ludwig von Beethoven, so good guess on that, and you get 2 points on the answer. Genentech is regarded as the world's first biotechnology company and became a subsidiary of Roche in 2009. It was the first to successfully express a human gene in bacteria and produced synthetic human insulin. What was its appropriate ticker symbol?
Is it DNA?
It is DNA. Good answer. So you get a full house too. Well done. Guys, did I start? I did start the recording earlier, right?
Yes,
Okay, good.
you did.
Okay. Julius, your choice of topic, please.
I'll take scientific mnemonics.
Scientific mnemonics and the first. An earlier mnemonic for this went, kings played chess on fiberglass stools. With the addition of another level in recent years, dear King Philip came over for good soup works better. What does either mnemonic help us remember?
So the animal kingdom.
Sorry, what is the answer?
Animal kingdom.
Can you explain that further?
It's the classification of animals from kingdom, phylum.
Okay, I'll grant
genera.
That.
I
think it is correct.
It is correct. I was looking for taxonomy as well because that was a required part of the answer, but that's why I asked you to expand on it. And when you came up with phylum, we can take it as correct. Okay. So it is the levels of taxonomic classification of living things, domain, kingdom, etc. Second question, Julius. We guarantee certainty, clearly referring to this dash mnemonic, is a rather self-referential way of remembering a property of the blanked out word. It is useful, though, when this property happens to be one of the fundamental constants of the universe. What does this mnemonic help us remember? And that's a five-letter blank.
If nothing, pass.
Anyone? I'll try. Fixed. FIXED.
No, it's not fixed, I'm afraid.
Anybody in our team?
I'll go. Yes.
Go for it.
This is the speed of light in vacuum.
This is the speed of light in vacuum. And the blanked out word is light. And the mnemonic refers to the number of letters in each word. Well done.
Great going, Jayant. Well
done. Okay, Jayant, your choice of topic now for Edrex.
Okay, I'll go with things happening along with the Olympics.
Okay, your first question. A magazine called Health and Strength organized an event to coincide with the 1948 Olympic Games in London. Which event that has become an annual feature? Jared, do you have an answer, please?
No, I don't.
Jared?
No, I pass.
Okay. I'll take it. Anybody, I think I'm 100% sure, but I just
want go for it. I think we have the same.
Okay, this is the Mr. Universe bodybuilding competition.
That is the right answer. It is the Mr. Universe competition. Well done. Second question, Jared. Which initiative first proposed in the 1930s finally was launched with the inauguration of the Olympics in October 1964. To showcase this new main line, some Olympic events were also held in the second largest city of the country, 400 kilometers away.
Okay, so 64 was Tokyo, so I'm guessing the bullet trains or the railway network in Japan.
Sorry, could you repeat that, please? It's indistinct.
Okay, so the fast train network in Japan, in particular the bullet trains.
That is right. It is the bullet trains or the
Shinkansen.
And this was used to move competitors across to Osaka as well. Well done. Okay, Glenn, your choice of topic.
All right, I'm just moving rooms because my wife is going to make a shake, and that's going to be noisy. Okay, all right. Okay. Okay, let's go with WTF song lyrics. That's, you know, I've been curious about that.
Okay, cool. Your first question. Name the song or the group. Song and group name are related, which produced these strange lyrics. To give them credit, it was under the influence of mind-altering substances, and one band member complained that the lyrics were nonsensical and would alienate their fans. The song was shelved after a few years as a result. A blind class aristocracy, back through the opera glass you see, the pit and the pendulum drawn, bygone, bygone, columnated ruins domino. Again, I'm going to play the...
Blind class aristocracy, back through the opera glass you see, the pit and the pendulum drawn.
The Alan Parsons Project?
Passes to your team.
Anyone? Stephen?
Queen?
Stephen? No, it's not Queen.
Okay, I got this, guys.
Go for it, Ajit.
This is Beach Boy Surfs Up.
That is the right answer. Beach Boys and Surfs Up. So it's related, both parts of the answer.
Nice.
Yeah, Glenn, your second question. The Billboard
this one number you two, should get Manila team.
Billboard number two song from Black Eyed Peas is surely not going to win them the Literature Nobel. What words are redacted in the song played and the lyrics reproduced below? Feel the shot, body rock, rock it, don't stop. Round and round, up and down, around the clock. Dash, 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 and dash, do it. Dash, dash, do, dash, do it. Get with us. You know what we say. Party every day. Party every day. I'm not going to play the clip. I don't know. Hope you enjoy the clip.
He's just saying Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Nice.
Days of the week. This is, I've got a feeling by the Black Eyed Peas.
Yeah.
Hey, no taking help from the kid. So
he just wants marshmallows.
Yeah. So marshmallow is the name of a DJ as well, right? So he's cluing you that it's marshmallow. Sorry, that's a bad one. Okay, Sumo, your choice of topic, please.
Patent and redesign, please.
Patent and redesign. Yeah, possible. In the 1930s, August Wojak became fed up with inefficiency and set out to engineer a better version. He studied a number of things such as letter frequencies, physiology, and ergonomics to design something that never really took off. I'm tired of trying to do something worthwhile for the human race. I simply don't want to change.
You want to sit down there?
What was he trying to redesign?
Thank you. Moisturizer.
Somebody needs to go on mute, guys.
Yeah, it's me. He was trying to design the keyboard, the Dvorak keyboard.
That is correct. It is the keyboard for typewriters, which was later used for computers as well. Excellent answer. Second question. Since 1838, when the U.S. Patent Office opened its doors, nearly 5,000 patents for X have been awarded in dozens of different subclasses, including electrocuting an explosive, swinging striker, choking or squeezing, more than for any other device. The redesign of this device has even drawn comment from philosopher Ralph Waldo Emerson. Build a better X and the world will beat a path to your door. What is X?
Is it the gun?
Not the gun, I'm afraid.
Okay, I'll take this, guys.
Go for it, Ajit.
Mouse trap.
Mouse trap is correct. Better wow. Mouse trap.
Wow. The marketing funder.
Yeah, being yes.
Nice.
Okay, good answer. Stephen, your choice of topic, please.
Desserts.
Yes, sir. So I was wondering when somebody would venture this. This pudding dessert, frequently served with custard, is archetypically British and is a plain flour pudding with currants or raisins. The currants or raisins give it what name?
Spotted dick.
Spotted dick is correct. Good answer. Second question. Baking in the oven for just 2 to 3 minutes makes meringue turn golden, but for dramatic effect, a blowtorch is frequently used to color and cook it. The original dessert created and named at New York's Delmonico's restaurant in 1876 in honor of a newly acquired territory had no requirement for this drama. Which dessert is this?
Baked Alaska.
Baked Alaska is correct. So you know your desserts and you get a full house on that. Answers. Good going. So Tequila Mockingbird, Asian Spring Festivals, or Quirky Time Zones for you?
What do you guys think? I think Quirky Time Zones is a better workability factor.
Yeah, I think so. I only know one Spring Festival.
Yeah, let's go for Quirky Time Zones.
Go for it, Ajit.
Yeah, Quirky Time Zones.
What connects the time zones of Eucla and nearby towns in the Northern Territory in Australia, Nepal, and the Chatham Islands in New Zealand?
I think maybe they're offset by 15 minutes.
15 minutes, yeah. Correct.
Yeah,
yeah, 15, yeah. Right? Because half an hour, many.
Yes, yes.
Okay, let's go with that. So these are the few time zones which are offset by 15 minutes.
I'll give that to you. It's actually offset by 45 minutes, but the
says not that we're looking at
15 minute difference. Yeah. Okay. Arizona is the only mainland USA state, with the exception of the Navajo Nation in the state's northeast corner, which spills into that does not follow what practice?
Daylight savings.
Do you guys, that was my first guess, but is there any other possibility? Arizona, why Navajo and all that?
They never bought into that concept only. I know Arizona doesn't follow daylight savings.
Okay, so stay with that then. That was the first guess anyway.
Yeah, I mean, we'll feel stupid if we go with something else, I think.
Okay, if there's no better answer, I'll stick with that.
Yes,
yeah.
Okay, stick with
it. Yeah, it does not follow daylight savings time.
That is correct. The first answer is always to be relied upon. It is does not follow DST. So, Urban Fervour, you get Asian Spring Festivals. First question. What Middle Eastern festival is considered by some to be a reference to certain houses being spared by divine intervention during the last of the 10 plagues of Egypt? There are other competing theories for the name.
Passover?
Passover.
Yeah, I think it's Passover.
Maybe.
Passover. Yeah.
Yeah.
They were passed over definitely by the plague.
Yeah. Okay. Our answer is Passover.
And that is correct. It is indeed Passover. Second question. The middle of April, 14th or 15th, is celebrated as New Year and major harvest festival in many cultures in India, including Sikhs, the Dogras, and the Bengalis. For Bengalis and Dogras, it is their New Year. All three festivals get their name from the name of which month, which starts on this day.
Is this the holy? No.
Yeah, holy. I don't know.
Diwali, holy. I don't know.
or is it Diwali? No. Or is it holy? It's
not
holy,
Diwali. Right? I don't
think. I think it's holy. Diwali, yeah.
Diwali. Yeah, holy.
April yata. Parang.
Yeah, holy. I think that's what.
Yeah.
Okay, let's try holy.
No. Okay.
Okay. Sige. We're offering holy.
That's not correct.
And it's just unfair, guys.
It's Vaisak. Vaisak.
Boishak or Vaisak, and the festivals are Vaisakhi.
Have fun, guys.
At least we learned something new.
Yes.
It's not worthy to learn, I think.
What do you think, guys? Right or left? I think right, no?
Right is better.
Actually, both seem okay.
The right is better.
We go right. We go right.
Right.
This animation comes from a superhero created for a 1972 BBC movie called Vision On. Named for the Dutch words for earth and person, together the term often means goblin. It started with Chicken Run and The Curse of the Were-Rabbit, and its films have earned over $1 billion in box office collection.
Earth person is something man. Can you go louder, Jen? I can't hear
you. No, I'm saying that Earth should be something like ERD, something like that.
Aardvark? Is it Aardvark?
Aardman it is.
Okay,
Aardman.
Is that something of the, like, is, yeah. Okay, good.
I can't remember. I know these movies.
Yeah, but I think it's Aardman. I've seen this. This is that.
Aardman.
That is correct.
Very nice, Soma.
It is Aardman animations. Very well done. Second question. Which English dialect verb describes a wind that blows forcefully with a dull roaring sound? The word has fallen into disuse and we know it chiefly from the title of an 1847 novel. Give us either the 6-letter verb or the 9-letter present participle form.
So the participle form is ing, just add ing. So that's somethinging.
Billowing.
The wind in the willows. But what's the novel? And also, it hasn't fallen out of use, I think. Below.
Oh, no.
No. Below, I think bellowing is a pretty common word, right?
Bellow.
Yeah.
Bellowing.
That's the best guess.
Okay, we'll go with bellowing, B-I-L-L-O-W.
That's not correct, I'm afraid. Oh, sure. Any guesses from Urban Fervour?
Bellow?
No, it's a bellow still continues to be in use.
What is not use? Oh,
of course. Yeah.
I know this, yeah. Shit.
Yeah.
You should have gone from the book. Jayant was on the right track.
The International Investment Management Company, Franklin Resources, Inc., better known as Franklin Templeton, is traded on the NYSE under which 3-letter ticker symbol?
I think it is Ben.
Ben,
B-E-N, I think.
B-E-N, correct.
Okay,
B-E-N.
Any other options? Okay, we'll go with that. B-E-N, Ben.
Ben is correct for Benjamin Franklin, whose image also appears in the logo. Very good. Okay, Urban Fervour, mystery bag left for you. In 1924, an attempt was made to include the sport in the Olympic Games, but this failed because of problems with distinguishing between amateurs and professionals. So, the first unofficial tournament for the sport took place along with the Olympics in Paris, with Czechoslovakia winning gold. This also accounts for the name of the tournament. Which sport and which tournament? So, we need both, yeah?
Mm-hmm. Which tournament?
Which sport and which tournament? Okay, so about distinguishing amateurs and professionals, I think that might be the clue. What would be what would make it difficult to distinguish amateurs and professionals?
Swimming.
No, but we need the tournament as well, no?
Shooting.
Cycling, Tour de France, I don't know.
Might be out of time, so could you have your final
answer? Stephen, why don't you offer the answer?
Cycling, Tour de France.
Not the cycling and the Tour de France, I'm afraid. Any guesses from TQM?
Can audience try?
Yes. The audience, go for it.
Is it the Chess Olympiad?
It is the Chess Olympiad. So the name of the Olympics. Good answer. Second question, Urban Fervour. Which 9 fundamental necessities that cannot be synthesized by the human body are represented by the letters of the mnemonic PVT, Private, Tim, Hall, where the A in Hall is not included?
Are these vitamins?
We must derive these items from our diet.
Vitamins, you think?
PVT, Tim.
Why not?
I was thinking vitamins, because that's the concept, right? You have to get it from
other source.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Okay. We're offering vitamins.
That's not.
No.
Any guesses from?
Or vital amino acids? You're asking for it.
That is the right answer. It is essential amino acids. And amino acids by themselves would not have been accepted. So you're looking for essential or actually indispensable. Mm. Okay. Final question of the first half to Urban Fervour. What Southeast Asian festival, usually celebrated in mid-April with ritual cleansing, ultimately gets its name from the Sanskrit word for astrological passage? Multiple South Asian communities celebrate different festivals with this name, with this word in its name.
Songkran,
I guess, because that's where they throw water at each other.
Southeast Asian,
Thailand.
Yeah. Puede.
So Songkran. Puede, no?
Yeah.
Any other answers? I think that's it. Okay. We're offering Songkran.
Songkran is correct. Very well done.
Songkran.
It derives from Sankranti, which is the word in Sanskrit. Okay, so we are at the end of the first half with TQM on 25 and Urban Fervour on 14. Do you want to continue or do you want to break?
Let's continue.
Go ahead.
So we flip the order. Urban Fervour goes first. Jovan, what's your choice of topic, please?
Historical figures, nickname Tamer. Thank you.
Very specific.
Yeah. First question. Which Bolshevik leader was named Scriabin at birth, but took the more industrial name we know him by from the Russian for sledgehammer when he joined Lenin? In the 1930s, he was second only to Stalin in the Soviet leadership and was appointed as the Minister of Foreign Affairs from 1939 onwards.
Molotov
is correct. Molotov, famous for the Molotov-Ribbentrop Pact and Molotov cocktail. Second question, Jomar. Judah, the Jewish priest, led the revolt against the Seleucid Empire in 167 BC. He acquired which nickname meaning hammer from his ferocity or choice of weapons? Hanukkah commemorates the restoration of Jewish worship at the Second Temple in Jerusalem after Judah removed the statues depicting Greek gods. He is also remembered through the name of the quadrennial international games for the Jews.
So this will be Judah Maccabeus or Maccabean.
Just bear with me for a second.
Need the nickname though, right?
Yeah, sorry. What is the answer, Joma?
Maccabean or Maccabeus?
Give me one answer, please.
Maccabean.
Pellet.
No.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm going to use my discretion and give it to you. It's slightly off.
Yeah, you should, yeah.
Actually, Maccabeus, but I'm going to give it to you. I hope you're okay with that. He came. I mean, he had the operator part of it.
I think Maccabeus. Yeah,
I think it's fine. Ajit, your choice of topic, please.
Hey, I'm scared to take early 20th century brand logos. But yeah, maybe I'll go for the brand logos.
Okay, the first question. Brand XY's mascot features the eponymous young girl walking in the rain with an opened umbrella and scattering Y behind her from a cylindrical container. She has been ranked one of the 10 best-known brand mascots in the US. Oh. The company's mascot and its motto, "When it rains, it pours," both originated in a 1914 advertising campaign developed to illustrate the point that XY was free-flowing even in rainy weather. Name the brand XY. Yeah, do you have an answer, please?
Rider wheel? No, sorry.
This is Sumo. Morton Salt.
Morton Salt is a right answer. Morton's good one. The second question, Ajit. In the early 1920s, the Washburn Crosby Company of Minneapolis got a lot of mail from its customers asking baking questions. The company thought that it would be better to sign the responses personally, so they combined the last name of its director with a first name that sounded cheery, wholesome, and folksy. The signature was penned by a company secretary who won a contest. What corporate mascot was born thus? Its evolution over the years is shown in pictures.
Betty Crocker?
Betty Crocker is the right answer. Good one.
Thanks, Sumo.
Okay, Julius, your choice of topic, please.
Batman movies.
Batman movies will be this. The Riddler in the Batman 2021 poses a set of puzzles to Batman to help him uncover the truth. Here is one. What does a liar do when he's dead? And you need a three-word answer, please.
You gave me the bad movie. He still lies.
I'll give you an opportunity to refine that.
Lie, lie, lie.
It has to be.
He just lies. I mean, he's.
I'm going to give it to you. It's actually he still lies.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, Julius, a second question. Answer this riddle from Batman Forever 1995. If you look at the numbers on my face, you won't find 30 in any place. What is this?
Oh God, this is good. If you look at the numbers, 13, 90 plays.
Okay, Julius, could you have the answer, please?
Your dress.
Who is the Batman? I don't know.
Your dress is getting good.
I'll try it. Is it a clock?
It is a clock. I'm glad you said clock and not watch, because again, I would have had to reduce my description. It strangely says clock and doesn't say except watch. I'm glad you said clock. Anyway, Utkarsh, your choice of topic, please.
I'll take trademark games.
Trademark games. The first person. Under what name did British manufacturer J. Jacques and Son Limited trademark the game of table tennis in 1901? Parker Brothers took the same trademark to the USA. Others had to use the term table tennis to avoid trademark infringement.
Is it ping pong?
It is ping pong. That's the right answer. Second question. George Nissen and Larry Griswold built the first modern version of this equipment in 1936 and trademarked it. Competition had to use the term rebound tumbler till the term got genericized and the trademark was lost. What game did Nissen and Griswold invent?
Is it squash?
Not squash, I'm afraid.
I'll go for this, guys.
Go for it, Dutch.
Trampoline.
Trampoline is the right answer.
Oh, nice.
Glenn, what's your choice of topic, please?
Let's try innovative film completions after actors' deaths.
In the 21st century. Name the film who still is shown here. In the film, the leader of a traveling troupe through a deal with the devil, takes audience members through a magical mirror to explore their imaginations. After the death of the actor, the role was recast with Johnny Depp, Jude Law, and Colin Farrell portraying physically changed transformations of his character as he travels through dimensions.
The Imaginarium of Dr. Parnassus.
That is the right answer, where it was Heath Ledger by doing the shooting. Second question, then. Which actor gained recognition in the 1980s as a child actor on the TV soap opera, The Young and the Restless? After his death in 2013, his brothers Cody and Caleb filled in for him in the ongoing movie. While this song, Paul Walker is correct. Both questions swiftly dispatched. It was Paul Walker on The Furious 7. He is depicted here with his brothers. Jayant, your choice of topic, please.
I'll go for unusual letters in the wrong alphabet.
First question. Until 1835, it was the 27th letter of the alphabet and a symbol which denoted a frequently used word. It got its name from the way the alphabet was recited. Sometime in the early 19th century, part of this recitative phrase got combined into a single term. Since then, it has remained a name of which symbol?
The ampersand.
Ampersand is correct. Good answer. Ampersand, which is recited as and per se and. Second person, Jayant. This word was written using the old English letter thorn. With the arrival of movable type printing and rationalization of the script, thorn was substituted with Y. Thus, this word survives with the unusual spelling in a few anachronistic names for old shops. Due to the substitution, the word is pronounced incorrectly, like an archaic pronoun. Which outdated word?
The. spell Y-E or thorn E.
That is perfectly correct. It's pronounced E as in curiosity shoppy, but where the E should be pronounced as the. Very good going, Jen. Stephen, your choice of topic. I'm guessing you won't go for flowering plants with Indian name origins.
Semi-enclaves
are countries who share a land border with just one country, but also have a part of the border on the sea. Monegasque, a dialect of the Ligurian language, is a language spoken in which country that is a semi-enclave?
Monaco.
Monaco is correct. Very good. This country on an island that is etymologically cognate with, one of the theories is it comes from the Sanskrit word Varuna, is actually a set of two semi-enclaves. Which country is this?
Bangladesh.
It's not Bangladesh, I'm afraid. It's open to it.
Omar, go for it.
East Timor.
It's not East
Timor. Okay, I'll go for
Ajit,
it.
Ajit, I'm quite sure.
I'm also 100%, but okay, you go ahead. Go ahead.
Okay. This is Brunei.
Correct.
It is Brunei, which is on the island of Borneo, and both of them supposedly derived the name from the Hindu god Varuna.
Utkarsh, you got the four passport changes thing.
Yeah.
I remember that question.
Okay.
Authors popularizing sports.
Her first contact with surfing was in Muizenberg, South Africa, in February 1922, when she and her husband set off on a year-long round-the-world trip as part of a trade mission of the British Empire expedition. Later that year, she learned to surf, standing up at the Waikiki Beach in Honolulu. She pursued this passion and helped introduce it in Europe. Which author is this?
Can you zoom in into the photo? Is it possible?
You are asking me to invoke the wrath of Rajiv Rai.
I'm guessing Agatha Christie.
Agatha Christie is good. Yes, well done. Yeah. And how you guess reached that question is a very good answer. So in the man in the brown suit, she writes, surfing looks pretty easy. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, next question. When his wife contracted tuberculosis, this author, who was anyways getting bored of his novel writing career, put a halt to it, relocated to Davos in 1894 and admitted her in a sanatorium. While his wife recovered, he focused on learning how to alpine ski and became adept at it. Smitten by this adrenaline rush, he wrote about it in the Strand magazine, contributing to the popularity of the sport and helping ignite the adventure tourism boom in Switzerland. Who is this?
Is this Hemingway?
It's not Hemingway, I'm afraid. It's open to your team.
Jayant or Utkarsh, do you have a guess? Or can I go?
Yeah, I have a guess, but please go ahead. I mean, I have a very weak guess.
Yeah, Arthur Conan Doyle.
And that is the right guess. Arthur Conan Doyle. His decision to kill Holmes in the final problem was hastened by his need to relocated to Davos. Go back to the suggestion. 70%. Okay, Urban Fervour, your choice of topic, please, for the team round.
Ano team? Yung ano na lang?
Hello?
Yung American, kasi nga?
Sige.
Yeah.
All right, okay, we'll try American radio station, please.
I mean, I thought it was a no-brainer to choose.
Mm-hmm.
WFMU is a radio station based in New Jersey that has a cult following around the world among fans of indie music. The logo of this radio station prominently features which two animals? To work this out, try and pronounce WFMU.
Woof.
Woofmu? Woofmu?
WF.
Wolf moose?
Wolf moose?
Wolf W. Wolf.
Wolf and moose. Okay. I'm good with that.
Okay. All right. We're offering wolf and moose, please.
Not correct, I'm afraid.
Is it a dog and a cow?
Wolf and emu.
No, dog and a cow.
It is, yeah. It is. It is.
Oh, woof. Nice.
All of it is woof and moo. So, yes, Giant, it is a dog and a cow.
Okay.
Second question. Very few campus radio stations tend to have listeners outside the campus they are broadcasting from. An exception is KZSU, the campus radio station of which West Coast University?
Okay, so, what are the West Coast universities?
UCLA,
UCLA,
Stanford, SU. I don't know.
My guess would be UC Berkeley. So, diba mga ano?
But it's KZSU. Is there a clue there?
Wala, KZ ata parang radio station. Ng...
So, SU. So, is it Stanford University? Because it says SU?
That's my guess.
Yeah, that I mean, they should put in a clue here. I mean, it seems obscure. Okay, we're trying Stanford University.
And that is correct. You had it worked out correctly. SU standing for Stanford University.
The funda, they don't allow people outside the university to listen. It's within the university.
Okay. Interesting, yeah.
You could write a letter of complaint again tomorrow.
Concept there, right? Anyway.
Okay, flowering plants with Indian name origin for Tequila Mockingbird. Your first question. What flower gets its name from the Sanskrit word for deep blue?
Neel something, right? So what neel?
Could it be lilac? Neela, lilac, just a guess.
No, it's an English flower name, but the deep blue, shit. Neel, something Neel. I don't know why I'm stuck with Neel. Karin, Pari.
No, but lilac could come from Neela.
Yeah, could be. So we'll go with that if there's no other guess.
Lilacs.
Okay, we'll go with lilac.
Lilac is correct. You didn't come up with any other guesses. It is lilac. And we've had the...
I don't know how... Yeah, well, you worked it out, Utkarsh, exactly.
Second question. Which aromatic oil obtained from the Southeast Asian shrub of the mint family gets its name from the Tamil for green leaf? It is used as a mosquito repellent for the common cold and in the perfume industry.
This is patchouli. This is patchouli for Tamil. So it's patchouli.
Yeah.
That's right, yeah.
Used in perfume for sure.
Yeah. So patchouli.
Patchouli.
That is correct. It is patchouli. Very well done.
Okay, that worked out better than we thought.
Yeah.
That actually came out in the Fundesliga set, I think. The patchouli. Yeah.
Yeah, it did. It did. Correct.
The perfume base notes set. Yeah.
Okay. So, do you want to see back left or right or before?
What? Hindi ko alam eh. Baka, or pwedeng
ka. Gusto niyo, kaliwa na lang?
Kaliwa na lang.
Okay, we'll go with left, please.
First question. The founders of this band, now a Nestle, the founders of this brand, now a Nestle subsidiary, held a contest to choose a logo. The winner was an unfinished charcoal sketch by Dorothy Hope Smith of Boston using the two-year-old Anne Turner Cook, who went on to become a mystery novelist. Which brand that gained international fame?
Gerber.
Because it's a baby, na. Okay. Okay.
Gerber.
All right. We're offering Gerber or Gerber.
Good answer. Second question. Identify this sport which has been described as part endurance race, part wrestling match, played mainly by women. Originating in the 1930s, the game was formalized by Leo Seltzer and author Damon Runyon, famous for his Broadway and Prohibition era stories involving gamblers, gangsters, and hustlers. It has had its ups and downs since, moving away from competition to scripted entertainment before its grassroots revival in the 21st century as pure sports, albeit with colorful dresses and pseudonyms.
So,
roller derby, na? Roller derby. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. All right. We're offering roller derby.
That's correct. Rated as one of the best actors of the film by a letter written by his character. Who is this?
Philip Seymour Hoffman.
Yeah.
Okay. We're offering Philip Seymour Hoffman.
And that is correct. So you've got all three questions in this mystery bag. Also in the Batman 2021, this one was posed to the Riddler by the Joker, making a cameo, who is his fellow inmate at Arkham. Riddle me this. The less of them you have, the more one is worth. What?
The time, guys. Less of time or something else.
Yeah, good one.
Sorry, what? What did you say, Ajit?
Time.
But the less of them you have.
What is them? Yeah, like them.
Hours.
And the more one is worth. Could be. Yeah.
Hours. Hours you have, the more. Hours.
Yeah. Because they are in prison.
Less of days.
So, probably go with hours. Okay. Yes. Okay.
We'll go with time expressed in hours.
That's not correct. Any guesses from Urban Fervour?
A roll time.
It's not time. The first time, but it is not time.
Watch the movies again.
So out of character.
Very deep.
Radio stations in the west of USA start with the letter K, and those in the east start with the letter W. Which geographic entity forms the east-west border for radio station naming?
So it's something which is right in the middle, right? So is it the Mississippi River?
My guess was Mississippi.
It started with W, right? Something like Washington River or something.
No. But just a river or something which divides the K's from the W's. So
but is there a reason for the K's and the W's? I mean, is there anything which has K on one side, W on the other side?
I
don't know. At this point, I can only think of Mississippi River.
Go for it.
Any other mountain or something? No, right?
No.
Okay.
We'll take Mississippi River.
And that is correct. It is the final question of this match. It's semi-enclave, appropriately named for the river shown here, the White River on the map, which defines the country, has a definitive article as part of the official name.
The Gambia.
The Gambia, right?
Yeah.
That is correct. The Gambia.
The Gambia is correct. So that brings us to the end, and the scores are 47 for Tequila Mockingbird and 35 for Urban Fervour.
Well done. And thanks for reading.
Well done. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you for reading.
See you again. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
But